Hello everyone, today again I am with you with the second chapter of biology, that is tissue, that is going on in the class. Okay, the date is 13th of August 2020, topic going on class 9th, tissues, which type of tissues you are studying, that is the connective tissues. Under connective tissues, today we study about the skeletal tissue. Skeletal tissue. Dear students, previously you studied about the epithelial tissue and different types of muscular tissue and some types of connective tissue. Remaining parts we will discuss today. Skeletal tissue, as name itself is enough, that it provides the framework of the body and help in locomotion of body organs. Okay, they also help in protection of vital organs, delicate organs which are lying inside in the body. Okay, as you are knowing, skeletal tissues are of two types. One is the cartilage and second is the bone. Skeletal tissue, cartilage and bones. If we draw the diagram of cartilage, you will get somewhat like this. Okay, this you can see, just for drawing. Again and again I am saying that consult to the book before drawing the diagram in copy. These tissues, cartilage tissue, are made up of living cells. Living cells, and living cells lies in the matrix. Matrix will non-living. And this matrix is semi-fluid. Semi-fluid matrix that contain the cartilage cells. The cells are called chondroblasts, which are covered in a semi-fluid matrix, and this fluid-filled cartilage cells are called lacunae. Fluid-filled cartilage cells are called lacunae. I am drawing big diagram. It is very small in structure. Okay, in this way. There is the matrix. This matrix contains collagen fibers, elastin fibers, glycoproteins, etc. and provide nutrition to the cells. The cells of lacunae, means cartilage, are divided continuously to increase the number, means they grow continuously. Okay? They are flexible, means compressible than bones. Okay, in this way they are. It is too scattered, it will be dense. And the surface of cartilage is covered by pericardium. Okay, if we name them, it will be the lacunae. Single lacuna, and inside the lacuna, this is the chondrocytes. Okay, when they are not covered in lacuna, they are called chondroblast. Okay, this is the matrix, non-living matrix, rich in glycoprotein, collagen fibers, etc. Okay, so these are, in this way the cartilage is arranged and divide continuously to increase the number of cells. Locations in the body where they are found, very less number of locations, like the end of long bones, end of long bones, pinna, do you know pinna? Pinna, some animals like ray fish or dolphins, they are whole body structure framework is made up of cartilage. They are called cartilaginous fish. Okay. At the in respiratory tract, they are found. Okay. Pinna. This part of the ear is called pinna. This one. Okay. So they are found there. At the end of nose here, there also cartilage is found. This cartilage help in movement and compressibility of the body. Okay. The cells are called chondroblasts, and if they are filled, covered with, this can be called perichondrion. Very easy to learn. If you learn chondrion, this one, then chondrocytes, chondroblast, perichondrion, in this way, matrix is very common word. So you can learn this and draw the diagrams also. Okay. Now, the second type of skeletal tissue is bone. Bone, similarly, the bones are also having living cells embedded in non-living matrix, and here also the if osteoblasts are embedded, covered by a fluid-filled membrane, then they are called here also means lacuna, they are called osteocytes. Okay, and the bone cells means osteoblasts are arranged in a form of concentric ring. Do you know the means of concentric? Concentric means many circles having same center. Okay, if we assume that this shape I am drawing is at the periphery of a circle, then this will be the center, and this type of circles are called concentric circles. Okay, they are arranged in a concentric ring. Okay, these. And this arrangement of the bone cells is called Haversian system. Which one? Haversian system. Similarly, like this, here also, and in this way, they are, that is, you can say it is periosteum. Okay. You have to draw such type of diagram here also, okay, in this way, here also, wherever, this is, so this middle is Haversian canal, the space between bone cells, स्टीशियल लैमिला एंड दीज आर बोन सेल्स दैट इज ऑस्टियोब्लास्ट. ओके, इन दिस वे दे आर अरेंज्ड सिमिलरली. बोन सेल्स आर ऑल्सो लिविंग एंड द मैट्रिक्स ऑफ बोन सेल्स इज 30% मेड ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक मैटर एंड 70% इनऑर्गेनिक मैटर एंड दिस इनऑर्गेनिक मैटर लाइक साल्ट्स कार्बोनेट्स ऑफ कैल्शियम मैग्नीशियम हाइड्रोक्सीएपेटाइट फॉस्फेट्स बिकॉज ऑफ देम इट इज हार्ड मीन्स नॉट इजी टू कॉम्प्रेस वाइल द लैकुना ऑफ द बोन आर ट्रेवर्स्ड बाय ब्लड वेसल्स एंड नर्व टिश्यूज नर्व सेल्स द ब्लड वेसल्स प्रोवाइड न्यूट्रिशन टू एंड एक्सचेंज ऑफ मटेरियल टू ऑस्टियोब्लास्ट. ओके, एंड दे ऑल्सो डिवाइड टू इंक्रीज द नंबर. ओके, बोन्स आर फाउंड ऑल ओवर द बॉडी दे फॉर्म द फ्रेमवर्क एंड हेल्प इन लोकोमोशन ऑफ बॉडी ऑर्गन्स बिसाइड दिस दे ऑल्सो हेल्प इन प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ डेलिकेट ऑर्गन्स दैट लाइज डीप इन साइड द बॉडी लाइक यू कैन टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ रिब केज. ओके, लंग्स आर प्रोटेक्टेड इन साइड द रिब केज एंड रिब केज इज मेड बाई द बोन्स. हर्ट इज प्रोटेक्टेड बाई रिब अंडर द रिब केज एंड रिब केज मेड बाई मेड ऑफ बोन्स. ओके, देयर इज द मूवमेंट स्ट्रक्चर एंड लोकोमोशन मीन्स मूवमेंट एंड लोकोमोशन तो दीज आर द फंक्शंस ऑफ द बोन्स. ओके, नाउ द नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ टिश्यू इन कनेक्टिव टिश्यू इज ब्लड. ओके, ब्लड मीन्स फ्लूइड कनेक्टिव टिश्यू फ्लूइड कनेक्टिव टिश्यू दिस फ्लूइड कनेक्टिव टिश्यू इज ब्लड एंड लिम्फ टू टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लूइड कनेक्टिव टिश्यू. ब्लड यू आर नो इट इज रेड इन कलर एंड फ्लो इन द ब्लड वेसल्स इट कंटेन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सेल्स लाइक द आरबीसीज डब्ल्यूबीसीज प्लेटलेट्स एंड ग्राउंड सब्सटेंस दैट इज कॉल्ड प्लाज्मा. ओके, WBCs are circular concave surfaces. WBCs has irregular shape and platelets also having irregular shapes and this is plasma that is the straw color liquid in which this is the matrix in which the different types of cells embedded and form the tissues. RBCs are responsible for transport of oxygen. WBCs are phagocytic in nature. Means they defend the body, protect the body from diseases and foreign organisms like the germs. Entrance of germs in the body. Platelets help in clotting of blood to prevent the excess loss of blood from the body. And this plasma helps in maintain pH, water balance, transport of carbon dioxide and different types of hormones, enzymes and nutrients to the blood cells. Okay, so these are the fluid connective tissue, blood. Okay, different types of cells. Second type of fluid connective tissue is lymph. Lymph are like in RBCs and platelets, while they have the WBCs and plasma. The plasma of lymph is transparent and it is extracellular fluid of the tissues, and it serves as an intermediate between the blood vessels and tissues. Okay, it carry extracellular fluid from the tissues to back into the blood, and the extra means extravascular means, as you are knowing, the blood capillaries are semi permeable. Some materials are squeezed out. They are collected by the lymph system, lymphatic system, and revert back into the blood. Okay, so this is the backup mechanism also. The lymph help in protecting the body from disease by killing the germs entered in the body. Okay, besides this, it also help in preventing the loss from the cells in the form of extracellular fluid. Okay, it also reduces the friction between the cells by moistening the cells from outside. So this is the lymph, two types of fluid connective tissue, blood and lymph. Now the next type of tissue, and I think it is the last type of tissue also in this chapter, it is the nervous tissue. Nervous tissue, as you know, nervous tissue helps in transmission of nerve impulses, means changes in the environment, back to the body. As a result, body will able to respond. Okay, simple diagram, better you will draw next year. They can be of any shape, star shaped, oval, somewhat similar the structure of bone cell is in this way. They are protected by the myelin sheath. This is the myelinated neuron. It is a nerve cell, diagram of a nerve cell in this way. They have the nucleus also, Schwann nucleus, Schwann cells are these. Okay, this have a prominent nucleus and rest of the materials in it. You should draw the diagrams by seeing from the book. It is a rough diagram. Okay, three parts are there. They have the axon terminals. Okay, these are called dendrites. Dendrites. Okay, this is called cell body or cyton, and this is axon. Okay, different parts are there. What they do? They receive the changes in the environment. from their dendritic tip and bring it to the cell body. From cell body it goes to the axon through axon at the axon terminals, where it is connected to another neuron, and in this way the message is conveyed from one neuron to another. Okay, this is called presynaptic knob, because one neuron is not directly in contact with the another neuron. There is a small gap between them. Okay, suppose this started the dendritic tip from here. So there, this space is called synapse, and this knob-like structure is called presynaptic knob. Okay. Some characters that they do not remain alive if deprived 5 minutes of continuous oxygen. They are not divisible and they do not repair also. Okay, but they are, this neuron is the unit of nervous system. Because of nervous system we are able to get the knowledge from our environment. We are able to decode the information we get. Suppose you suddenly touch a hot object, you will feel the hotness of the object, you will lift the utensil which is hot. That is possible because of this nervous system and nervous tissue. Okay, if there will no nervous tissue, we will unable to respond to the stimuli, to changes in the environment. Okay, this is all about the different types of tissues of this chapter. In class 9 you have to study about the 4 animal tissues, and I make you study about the 4 animal tissues. Okay, one is the epithelial, second is the muscular, third is the connective, and fourth is the nervous tissue. Okay, you have to study them properly and watch the video again and again, and if you get the information properly, if you are able to understand, then please like, subscribe and share the video. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.